Was it freaky to see the Samara performer? I don't know, you run into her when you're going to the bathroom or you're going to eat something. And was it weird or?
Yeah, she stays in character the whole time. But it was also fun to see the whole makeup process, which takes like about 5 hours and to take off like a couple hours. So that was fun to see. But yeah, she's pretty creepy.
What do you think that makes her, I mean, not the performer, but the character special? Because there are many monsters in movies. What is the one thing that you would say that is special about Samara?
I think the more you get to know her backstory, you start to feel for her.
Like, you don't really see her face. Mm-hmm. And I think, like, when you don't see, it's way scarier.
Yeah. One scene that you are going to remember, like, I know, in 20, 30 years, you're going to look back and say, I remember that.
Shooting it? I remember the day that Johnny Galecki was electrocuted. Because he was in the car. And there were lights inside the car. There was water running through this car. The car was upside down. And they had to, Johnny Galecki had to like slide into the car upside down. And like having Johnny Galecki wet and like pretending to be electrocuted. And then when they said cut, seeing him, like hearing him ask for a cappuccino, it was kind of funny.
That's a professional.
Yeah. Right. Upside down. Like, give me a cappuccino.
What do you think that is the future for this world? Because nowadays, you know, everybody's doing video in their phones, etc., etc. Is there something that you would like to see in the next chapter?
The possibilities are endless, really.
Now you might get a new technology, like in 2 days.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah, virtual reality.
Yeah.
Virtual reality Samara.
That's pretty scary.
Yeah. And Samara with a rainbow, you know, the rainbow tongue, whatever. That's going to be, that would be extra scary.
Extra scary.
Talking about scary, are you the kind of people that can watch one of these movies alone? Because let me tell you what, I saw this film at the Paramount screening, at the lot, by myself.
Oh.
And that was quite an experience.
Scary.
Yeah. That was very scary.
Why did you do that?
I don't know. I think it's kind of a long story, but the point is that I cannot watch scary movies alone. Can you? Are you okay with that? No?
No. I myself called my brother to come and watch it with me, The Ring, when I wanted to re-watch it.
Wow.
Yeah. It didn't really help because I think he was more scared than I was, so.
Did he call you after like 7 days?
7 days. My friends were pranking me.
Wow.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But they were saying, set the journey.
Is there any advice? Let's say that people, you know, start watching the movie at home, the Blu-ray, and they feel something weird going on, and they start seeing like Samara is kind of going outside the screen. Is there any advice you can give them, or they are doomed?
Just be nice to her. Be pleasant. If you're in England, make her a cup of tea. Just be invite her into your home, and I don't know, she might treat you nicely.
Yeah. That's lovely. Yeah. That's lovely. Yeah. Thank you so much for your time, guys.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you so much.